Hi everyone, I'm Cong Yuedeng from Stanford University. In this video, I'm going to present our work Vector Neurons, a general framework for SO3 equivariant networks. Rotation invariance and equivariance are widely discussed in the 3D deep learning community. Such a property is desired in a variety of point cloud processing tasks, including classification, segmentation, and surface reconstruction. In these tasks, you would like your output to be coherent to the input, no matter how you rotate the input point cloud. In most existing 3D datasets, all shapes are aligned to a canonical pose, but shapes in the wild like what you scan from a depth sensor do not have such canonical poses. While data augmentation may alleviate this issue, the 3D rotation group SO3 is pretty large and such an exhaustive augmentation can be resource consuming. Therefore, we're still looking for neural networks that are naturally equivariant to SO3 transformations. A group of previous works have been trying to tackle this setting by creating handcraft features at the input layer, but these features are usually problem-specific and are just invariant instead of equivariant. Recently, more systematical approaches have been introduced. Specifically, there are tensor field networks and SE3 transformers, which achieve equivariance using spherical harmonic basis and the SO3 group representation theory. However, both frameworks not only involve an intricate formulation, but are also restricted to convolutions and rely on relative positions of adjacent points, making them hard to incorporate into some existing pipelines. Most related to us are the works using geometry-aware 3D representations that can encode 3D pose information into their latent spaces, but they usually require Siamese training with relative poses. In this work, we propose a simple yet versatile framework called the Vector Neurons, with acronym VN, for constructing SO3 equivariant point cloud networks. We'll show that a diverse collection of network building blocks can be rewritten into the VN form, acquiring rotation equivariance while preserving their basic properties. Neurons in standard artificial neural networks are built from scalars. When stacked into another list, these neurons form a C-dimensional latent feature in RC, but we hope to realize the action of SO3 in the latent spaces. To this end, we lift the neuron representation from a scalar Z in R to a vector V in R3, leading to what we call a vector neuron. For an orderless set of n points in a point cloud, we can consider a collection of n such vectorless features. Similar to standard neural networks, the number of latent channels C can change between layers via mapping F with learnable parameter theta. Using this representation, the action of a rotation is made simple to implement as it involves the application of a standard rotation matrix. Here shows a comparison between classical scalar neurons and vector neurons. For a point cloud with per point features, the latent space tensor is now n by c by 3, where n is the orderless dimension and c the ordered dimension. With the vectorless latent representation, we can then facilitate equivariance in point cloud network architectures. We begin by introducing the linear operator. Given the vectorless feature v in RC by 3 and the weight matrix w in RC prime by c, we define the linear operation as directly multiplying w from the left, which gives a c prime by 3 output. The equivariance property of this operation is easy to verify, as it commutes with any rotation matrix R multiplied from the right. Note that we omit a bias term as an addition of a constant vector that could interfere with equivariance. Per neuron nonlinearity is key to the representation power of neural networks. Especially useful are functions that split the input domain into two half spaces, such as ReLU. In the case of VN, a 3D version of these nonlinearities is needed. Instead of committing to a fixed frame as in the classical designs, we propose to dynamically predict the direction from the input vectorless feature. We then generalize a classical ReLU by truncating the portion of a vector that points into the negative half space of the learned direction. More formally, given an input vectorless feature V, for each output vector neuron V prime, we predict the feature vector Q and the direction vector K. is then clipped if it points to the negative half space defined by k, or unchanged if it points to the positive half space. Other types of split case functions, like the leaky ReLU, follow immediately from this definition. For more details, please refer to our paper and the supplementary material. Pooling is widely used when aggregating local or global neighborhood information. While mean pooling is easy under rotations, we also define a VM max pooling layer as a counterpart to the classical max pooling on scalars. Given a set of vector lists, we learn an element-wise signal of data-dependent directions k, and then compute the element of v that best aligns with k and select it as our global feature. Here shows an illustrative figure of the VM max pooling. It's similar to what we have done in the nonlinearity. Normalizations often give rise to significant performance improvements. Layer and instance normalizations are done per sample and thus can be trivially generalized to VN networks, where the distributions are normalized with respect to vector distributions in R3. In contrast, batch normalization aggregates statistics across all batch samples. While technically possible, in the context of rotation equivariant networks, aggregating across arbitrarily rotated inputs would not necessarily be meaningful. We instead apply batch normalization to the invariant component of the vector least features by normalizing the two norms of the vector least features. We now introduce our invariant layer, which can be appended as needed to the output of the equivariant VN layers. Key to our approach is the idea that the product of an equivariant signal by the transpose of an equivariant signal is rotation invariant. Specifically, we can produce a coordinate system T from input feature V and re-V in this coordinate system. In practice, when considering a set of equivariant vectorless features, we concatenate each feature with a global mean and then produce a matrix TM for each element with a shared vector neuron MLP. With all these building blocks, vector neuron becomes a simple yet versatile framework. It is also lightweight in terms of the number of learnable parameters. We now show how to plug VN into two widely used 3D learning architectures, PointNet and DGCNN, with minimal modifications. DGCNN comprises convolutions, but the message passing is on dynamic graphs whose edges are not directly embedded in R3. As shown here, our VN DGCNN only requires a straightforward modification. Instead of stacking adjacent points horizontally into a six-dimensional vector, we stack them vertically into a 3x2 tensor. PointNet is free from convolutions. Together with DGCNN, these two backbones are representatives of the richness of pointcloud networks. Again, it can be rewritten into a VN network easily. One issue here is in the first input layer. When the inputs are 1x3 point coordinates, applying VN linear directly can result in all output features being linearly dependent. To tackle this, we add an edge convolution at the input layer to lift the features to higher dimensions. Here's a more straightforward explanation for VN PointNet. We now show our experimental results on three core tasks in pointcloud processing: classification, segmentation, and neural implicit reconstruction. Classification and segmentation are rotation invariant tasks, while reconstruction is rotation equivariant. In classification and segmentation, we adopt three train and test settings, ZZ, ZSO3, and SO3SO3, where Z stands for data augmentation with rotations only around the Z-axis, and SO3 for arbitrary rotations. Here are our classification results on ModelNet40. We compare our VN networks to other rotation-sensitive methods and rotation-robust methods, which takes only point coordinates as inputs. Compared with their non-equivariant counterparts, the VN networks attain constantly good results on all the three settings, which indicates their robustness over rotations, especially in the ZSO3 case where the test set contains unseen rotations in the train set. Even in the SO3-SO3 case with abundant train time data augmentation, The rotation-sensitive networks cannot perform as well as the equivariance by construction in VN networks. On the other hand, in the ZSO3 and SO3-SO3 cases, the VN-DGCN outperforms all other equivariant or invariant methods with only point coordinate inputs. For par segmentation on ShapeNet, we can see similar results. VN-DGCN still achieves the best performance, even compared to the methods that additionally use surface normals. Finally, we show our results in neural implicit reconstruction, where we follow the experimental settings from ArcNet. For the equivariant framework, we adopt the VN pointnet encoder, a global vectorless feature Z, and the decoder applied to the invariant features between Z and the query point X. Instead of data augmentation with axis around rotations, here we train with no rotation, denoted by I. Compared with the original ArcNet, our VN ArcNet shows excellent coherence in reconstructing shapes in any poses, with a minor loss in accuracy in the II case. Here are the visualizations. We can see that ArcNet is extremely sensitive to rotations, where in the ISO3 case, it totally fails. Even in the SO3-SO3 case, it still shows its limitation, but our VN ArcNet is stable across rotations. Here are more examples. While our method shines under arbitrary rotation settings, it has a minor performance drawback on aligned input shapes. Specifically in the task of reconstruction, our VN ArcNet was not able to match the reconstruction quality of vanilla ArcNet. Moreover, in future works, we may consider generalizing vector neurons to higher dimensional point clouds or to other transformation groups such as a full affine group. Thanks for watching.